you, but you still ain't calling. I left my cell, my pager, and my home phone at the bottom. I sent two letters back in autumn, you must not have got them. There probably was a problem at the post office or something. Sometimes I scribble address.
If you made it to this portion of the video, thank you so much. Go ahead, like, subscribe. Follow this journey of me, John Bean, becoming a chiropractor and putting a new spin on the whole profession. And in this portion of the video, of the vlog, whatever you want to call it, I'm going to be handling and narrowing down the reasons why I want to become a chiropractor and what I feel, what I want to bring to the profession as a potential chiropractor student as well. Anyways, number one, I feel called to do it. Now, if you don't know, I am a Christian. I have a faith in Jesus Christ, and I believe he's my Lord and Savior. I'll put that out there. Like, I'm not going to hide it, anything like that. If you have any questions, you can go ahead and DM me, comment down. I'll be happy to answer any question that I potentially can as a human being. You know what I'm saying? But anyways, that'll get that into a different story. But anyways, this is what I feel like the Lord wants me to do. I feel like he wants to put me in a position to help others in a really almost hypnotic profession. And I'm not dogging all chiropractors or anything. I don't know who's watching this, but there's a lot of bad chiropractors out there, and a lot of them get a bad rep about pseudoscience. And I get it may not be everyone's thing, and I don't believe that everybody should get adjusted, and that's why they may call it pseudoscience. Like, you may not be able to feel that full potential of yourself being able to do what you usually do after becoming adjusted. You know what I'm saying? Like, not everybody feels the same way after it. So I want to, like I said before, I want to bring a different brand to this profession. And if that means I go a different route and I'm not like the other students that I go to school with, that's A-okay. But like I said, I don't believe everyone should get adjusted. And somebody that's worked at a chiropractor clinic for almost 4 years during my undergrad, some of the things that I've been taught and learned seeing hands-on is I see the same patients, which is, that's okay. Like, if you feel better going a lot, then do it. But I want to be able to solve the problem. Like, I have such a, I don't know if it's a A-type or B-type brain. I want to be able to solve the problem. And if I can get you in as a patient, if I can get you in, and if we can solve your case and get you out back into the world, back into your life where you don't have to come reoccurring, maybe, yeah, sure, come on, go see me. You can get a massage if you want to get adjusted, do it if you feel more mobile. But I want to get you back out there, you know what I'm saying? There's too many chiropractors that keep you reoccurring, and that you have the same problem. Well, I don't want you to rely on adjustments is what I'm trying to say. And I want to bring a different spin onto that profession and kind of change that perspective as a doctor of chiropractic, not like a medical doctor. I'm not going to be a medical doctor. And so yeah, number one, that's what I feel called to do. Number two, I don't know if this is like an actual point, but another reason why I want to become a chiropractor is, I've fallen between a physical therapy mindset, but I also feel like adjusting can help make you more mobile. Your AC joint right here, when I started doing lateral raises a lot a couple years ago, it was hurting and I was not mobile. I went ahead and got that AC joint in place, and now I'm a lot more mobile. And that's what I'm trying to talk about. And I want to have that knowledge and that brand of education alongside doing my research on a physical therapy aspect, learning new movements. What is impinging on your muscles that's immobilizing you to not move as well as you were, if that makes any sense. I hope I worded that right. But that's the kind of brand I want to bring and cultivate into my practice and what I want to do throughout all this. Like I said, I don't have a lick of knowledge when it comes to chiropractic. I have not stepped on a chiropractor campus as a student. This is all throughout experience working in one, and sometimes I feel like that experience can outweigh most of the stuff you learn in a classroom, and I'm sure many of you can agree with that. But at the same time, once you get that brand of education and you're around that atmosphere, it starts to change and hinder a little bit. And I'm sure I'll pick up more. I'm gonna learn so much when I'm in school. And like I said, this is all what I'm learning right now, I'm an undergrad. I just want to make that clear. I know nothing. I'm not even a doctor. I haven't even got my bachelor's of science yet. I'm about to graduate. But yeah, so those are my main two reasons why I want to become a chiropractor. I hope that kind of clears it up. And honestly, what's your reason? Like, what is your why of why you want to do it? I can see myself waking up every day as a chiropractor, helping and taking a case from a patient and moving forward and just diving in and learning more about what we can do to make that person's lifestyle even better. That's what I want to do when I wake up, and that's exactly is my why. So if you're looking and you're watching this video wondering what you should do, if you should choose any type of doctoral profession, think about it. Really, really, really think about why you want to do it. And I don't want you to think of money, because all of them make money. Anybody can make money. It's, are you happy enough? And without that money, are you happy? You know what I mean? So, like I said, maybe I'll even throw in the story. So first, I wanted to be an optometrist. And the reason why I wanted to be an optometrist is because I started Googling, are chiropractors respected? Are chiropractors legit? Are chiropractors real? And all of those sources were from those who did not have good experiences. And trust me, there is a lot of negativity, and it will spill out into your brain. And don't take that. You look at yourself in the mirror and look at your heart and look where you want to go. And I don't mean to take, and I don't mean to take this into like a motivational speech or anything, but I almost went one way because I had other friends that were going to be medical doctors saying, yeah, that's not legit. You shouldn't do that. You should do this profession. And I looked up to those people. They were older than me. I looked up to them almost as an older brother. And I thought, you know what? I should. I did. I worked in a little clinic for a while as a just an eye doctor, like assistant, basically. I was like, nah, this ain't it. I want to do chiropractic. Health and wellness is my deal. I want to be able to help patients and get them out there and do whatever, you know what I'm saying? Live your life. So, like I said, thank you for watching. Like, subscribe. Videos, I'm going to try to pump them out weekly. And that is going to be difficult to do, but because I am working two jobs. I'm taking 6 hours, which is two classes. I am trying to eat a lot. I'm trying to sleep at least 8 hours. And you know, I kind of like to hang out, you know what I'm saying? So this is gonna be a grind. This is gonna be difficult. But if there's one thing I've learned, is that this difficulty is uncomfortable. And if I wanna get anywhere in life, I have to put myself into those uncomfortable situations, because there's gonna be moments where it's gonna be me versus somebody else, and it's who gets uncomfortable the most and drops out of whatever it is. So put yourself into those uncomfortable situations so you can grow yourself and see your full potential, because damn, you have no idea what you can accomplish once you have a narrow mind and a narrow path and you go straight to that goal. Peace out.